Thanks for watching Mid-Morning this Wednesday. You may have heard Matt and the morning crew talking about the start of meteorological spring this morning.
I will confess to being a little bit of a skeptic of meteorological spring. Uh-huh. It is today, March 1st is the start. Astronomical spring, or what the rest of us just call spring, is 19 days away on March 20th.
Philistines.
So we wanted to talk to our two meteorologists about the difference. Mm-hmm. I did find the start of this meteorological season business, and it's been going on for quite a while. It's been used for record keeping for about 100 years.
Yeah.
You two are like, obviously. Okay, what's the deal? Like, we all learned about spring and summer and fall and when the equinox is and when the solstice is, how the sun's here and this is where the earth is. So why did you guys have to make up your own seasons?
Well, Matt and I got together about 100 years ago and we had a beer.
And
we decided that this is the way that we would like to take over the world.
What's
is
the
by
reason?
Creating
what's
seasons.
The reason?
It's record keeping. This is just lines everything up a little bit more clearly. So we do meteorological spring, which is March, April, May. We do summer that follows that and fall the fall, 3 months at a time. And basically the way it lines up, the 90 hottest days of the year tend to fall during meteorological summer, and the 90 coldest days of the year tend to fall during meteorological winter, and it's just more even.
Well, and it's set too, so the equinoxes and the solstices, they can change by a couple of days. So when you're looking at the actual total of spring versus meteorological spring, it doesn't come out to be even every time, which makes it difficult to look back and say, okay, like everyone likes to tweet us and ask, how does this spring compare to last spring or the one before? People want to know that difference.
Well,
and
don't
that's
you
how
just
we
do an average
trends.
Anyway? I guess when you're doing like a count of precipitation, maybe you're not averaging
Well, you do it month by
day,
month. Otherwise, so, how are you working that?
Temperature-wise, usually it's like an average, right? But you're right, precipitation, that makes sense. So I get it from record keeping, but like why should any of us really care? Like,
because it works better.
It's just for your record.
Well, it does.
Like today
it
doesn't feel like the start of spring. It almost never
but
does.
But does December 1st feel like the start of winter?
Yes, it does.
Yeah, exactly. And does what does this work out? April, May? Does June 1st feel like the start of summer?
Yes.
Yes, it does.
That's
June. It's June. That's summer. Summer's not May. June 1st? You're telling me like you have to wait till like June 20th, 21st, and you're like, you know, now I'm going to go to the
longest day of the year. My son, Seth, was born on the longest day of the year.
But like that's also not always true.
Oh, well, now.
Like that.
Fake weather coming at you right now. We're going to believe you two.
Okay,
well, like, you know, the equinox isn't always exactly 12 and 12. Like, there's a little bit of shift.
The only reason that I think this matters to regular people is that when you're talking about averages and temperature change over time, if you're using winter in a meteorological sense versus winter in an astronomical sense, like, you want to make sure you're talking about the same thing.
Absolutely.
No one has to worry too much about this. No.
And it's fun to get in these arguments.
It's just something that irritates me every 3 or 4 months, and we just have some fun.
There
Old man shouts at a cloud. Way to go, Jason.